after hitting lower circuits for the past two trading sessions. We did speak to the management yesterday to provide some clarification with regards to the auditors, but there's really no respite, and obviously the street is very uncomfortable right now. Prashant, what can we expect today, and what are the latest developments?
I mean, actually, there is no latest development. That's essentially what I wanted to say. So the last actual sort of information which came out was when we spoke with the Manpasand management yesterday. By the way, I just want to say that look at the number of stock traded in the Manpasand shares. I mean, 50,000 shares, that is nothing, right? And the stock is down 10%. And actually, it was down 20% yesterday, and volumes were around that 50,000-60,000 share mark. So, I mean, the fact is, it's not as if there is huge institutional selling. Maybe there is a lot of institutional selling waiting to get done, but the point is, there are no buyers on the other side, right? So, the amount of stock is pretty limited. So, you know, you look at the, 45-50% price fall over the last 3 days, and the kind of opinion is very stark, right? I mean, one opinion, which I think is what you're seeing reflected in the market, is that, well, there is hanky-panky. You can't trust the financials, the numbers. There was this blog which was written, which is going viral again. I remember the first time it came out, the stocks the next day morning sold off 12-14%, and then it recovered. And I think the management came on air, clarified, etc. Now with the auditor resigning, I think that is back in circulation, and people are really questioning why would the auditor, like one of the big four, Deloitte, really step away unless there were serious concerns with the numbers. We haven't heard from the auditor. We haven't. There were reports that Deloitte has written to MCA. We reported on that. The other point of view, that is one point of view. The other point of view, and this is also, I've spoken to a few investors, and they are telling me that maybe this is just a case of, I mean, for the lack of a better way to put it, lack of understanding. I mean, it's basically misunderstanding or maybe kind of a standoff.
Lack of information.
Yeah, so essentially, I mean, the story goes that, there was information asked, the information was provided by Manpasand to Deloitte, in a delayed fashion. The cutoff for announcing results was 30th. The date was approaching. Manpasand went ahead and announced that they will announce the results on such and such date without waiting for the auditor to sign off on the books, right? And that kind of set off Deloitte, and they kind of stepped off from being statutory auditors for Manpasand. So, but you know, if you believe the second line of thought, like second line of thinking, then it's just that. It's just auditors stepping off because dates did not match. I mean, it's just that. It's not nothing to do with financials. We don't know which one is correct, but they're very two different things, opinions which are out there at this point. And the implications of both those two are very, very different, right? I mean, if you go with the first one, then it is very, very serious.
Well, maybe a clarification from the auditors is something that the market would really want at this point in time. So maybe Deloitte should probably come out with a statement, maybe come out with a clarification with regards to this.